हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर प्रमोद बोकडे फ्रॉम प्रियदर्शिनी भगवती कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग. वेलकम यू ऑल इन दिस वीडियो ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज ऑन लेटेक. फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज आवर 10th वीडियो इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज. इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल सीरीज वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न हाउ टू इंसर्ट द ग्राफिक्स इन योर लेटेक डॉक्यूमेंट. नाउ मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम्स इट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू इंसर्ट the figures, the diagrams, the graphs, the circuits and many more in our LaTeX document or in our book or thesis. So in this video tutorial we are going to learn how to insert these graphics in our LaTeX document. So further in this video we will see how to insert the images. Your images should be in .jpeg, .png, .eps or .pdf format. Further, we will see how to resize these images, how to rotate the images, how to place the images, two or more images side by side, and finally, we will see how to create the list of figures in LaTeX document. So, without wasting much more time, let us quickly jump into the TeX Studio. Friends, I have recommended you the TeX Studio because it becomes easier for the user to insert many more commands very easily without remembering it. So let us quickly jump into the TeX Studio. So I have already opened this TeX Studio environment. So for that, I will quickly create a new file. So for that, I will go into the file menu, click on new, and it will create a blank document. Now here, this is nothing but your source code file. Now here in this case, let us quickly create one new file article. So I will zoom it. Now, to create the new article, we have already seen we have to go into the wizard, then click on quick start. Then I will keep all the parameters as the default parameters. I am not going to change for the demonstration purpose. Depending on the requirement, we have to change these parameters. We have to change the document class. We have to change the font size. We have to change the paper size and so on. But for this demonstration purpose, I am not going to change this default parameters. Now for inserting the graphics, one point you have to note here that you have to check this GraphicX package. If you miss to include this GraphicX package in your LaTeX document or source code, your graphics will not be included. So this is the main package that we have to include inside this source code. So I will tick on this GraphicX packages. By keeping all the remaining parameters as it is, I will quickly click on OK. So as I will click on OK, it will produce the template. So as in the template, we are having the two part. One is the preamble before the begin document command. These packages are included. So this is inside your preamble. Now again, make sure that this preamble part should consist of the package slash use package GraphicX. If it is not there, you have to write down this command backslash use package GraphicX command. So as we have already ticked in that dialog box while creating the article, it is automatically included here. So now inside this body of your document, let us quickly see how to insert the images. So for demonstration purposes, I have kept my JPEG files in one of the folder. I will recommend you whenever you are preparing any document or report or book, you keep all the figures or the images in one folder. Now, let us see how to insert the figures. So for that, what I will do here, now related to that, you can write down the commands. If you remember the commands, you can write down the commands manually. But TextStudio has one good facility that it has provided a button for inserting the graphics. And that button is inside this wizard button. So when I will click on this wizard, there is one option here, insert graphics. So I will click on insert graphics. So it will open one dialog box. So let us quickly go through this dialog box and see how the images can be included inside the LaTeX document. Now, the first parameter is file. Now, here you have to select the path for your file. So click on this folder icon. So once I will click, here it will open a dialog box. So here in this case, you have to select your figure. You have to select the path where you have to store your figures. So I have stored my figures in D folder inside this LaTeX tutorials. Sorry, I have some another folder. I will go back again D. Then I have, sorry, on desktop I have saved it. So on desktop, I have this LaTeX tutorial folder and inside that I have figures. So here I have the different figures stored inside that folder. So I will click this figure that I have to insert inside the LaTeX document. So let us, I will select this Raspberry Pi A model suppose. So I will click on this figure and click on open. So it will include my figure. If you see here, previously it was a blank, but now here there is a path for my figure. Then the second option is graphics option, width and height. Now user has to decide how much should be the width and height of your figure. Now here if I will click on width, it is asking for the width of your figure. So different options are given, line width, centimeter, it is in millimeter. I generally prefer to give the height or the width in centimeters. So I will click on centimeters. You can also select millimeter or you can select the line width. Line width means the complete width of your line in your document. So I will prefer the centimeter. I will select the centimeter. Then let us consider that I will consider the width as 6 centimeter. Let us select how much height you have to keep for your figure. So I'll click on height. Again, I will take the unit as centimeter and let us height for my figure. I will select it as a 4. So according to your figure, you can keep the dimension. Sometimes your figures are very, very small. So you need to keep the dimension small. And sometimes your figure or diagram is very large. So you need to increase the width and the height of your figure so that it should be clearly visible in your output document. So I have selected the width and height for my figure. You can also define by using this command width and height, you can put here. So I will select it from here. Then the second checkbox here is center horizontally. So in standard document, if you have seen, your figures are always centered aligned. So if I uncheck this box, so in the output document, your figures will be left aligned. That seems to be somewhat odd. So always your figure should be center aligned. So I will put a tick mark on this center horizontally option. Then below that you are having place in figure environment. Now I will recommend you to keep it ticked so that we can have the more options. If I will not select this one, some of the options get disabled. Now, what is the use of these options? So when I will check it, now you can give the name to your figure. Now you can include and that name to the figure, it is called as the caption. Now this caption can be included above the figure or below the graphic, above the graphic or below the graphics. So if you see the standard documents, always the name of the figures, they are included below the graphics. So I will select below graphics. If you want that your name should be displayed above the graphic, then you can insert the option, or you can select the option above graphic, but I will select below graphic. Now here you can give the short name to your graphic. Now I will prefer to give the complete name for my graphics, so I will write down here Raspberry Pi model. Raspberry Pi model. Then the next option is label. So label is nothing but the short name that you have to give for your figure, so that if you want to refer this figure somewhere else, in that case you can refer that figure by considering this label. So let us give here, I will give the short label as RPI 1, suppose. You can give any name, you can give any related name to your figure. So I will recommend to give a meaningful name or meaningful label to your figure, so that while referring to that figure you can easily remember this name. Then the next button comes to be the position. This is important. Now under this position you are having the various options. Now here the top. So when you check this, your figures will always be inserted at the top of the LaTeX document or at the top of the page. If you check this bottom, your figure will be inserted at the bottom of your page. If you check this page, so your figures will be inserted on the different page for the figures. I will prefer to check here. That means whenever I am inserting that figures, that should remain there. So it is a better practice to use the here button. So I will select here and span two columns. If your document is having the two columns text, so you can span your figure within two columns. So I will keep as unchecked because my document is a single column document for the time being. So I will uncheck this. Now I have set all the parameters now here. Now I will click on OK. So once I will click on OK, it will automatically produce the commands related to insertion of your graphics. So if you see here, it has created the commands backslash begin figure. H stands for here that we have selected. Then we have selected the centering option. So that's why it has created centering. Then that include graphics gives you the command to include the graphics. We have set the width as 6 cm, height as 4 cm. And in this curly braces, it has given the path. So already that path we have selected there. So instead of remembering all these commands, it is easy to use the button wizard and then include insert graphics. So that will be easier for you. So as we have already seen how to set the dimensions, now here captions is nothing but the name to your figure or name to your graphics. And again, we have given the label for the referring purpose or the citation purpose. So I have inserted the image. Now what I will do here, I will quickly compile this file and run this source code, so that let us see what will be the output file. Now here this file is compiling. It will take some time to produce the output document. Definitely your output document will always be in the PDF form. Now let us wait for some time. This is taking more time to compile. As it is the first time of compilation, it generally takes more time. The next compilations will take some less time as compared to first one. See, this process is excited normally. So it has produced or it has inserted the images inside this LaTeX document. So as we have seen, we have this figure selected, and automatically the LaTeX has given the figure number. It has given the figure number. In this code, we have not given anywhere as figure number one. So as we go on inserting the different figures one below the another, the LaTeX will automatically go on numbering this figure. So here, this caption that we have given, Raspberry Pi model, that is given as the name to this document, name to this figure. Now, this is how we can insert the graphic or images inside the LaTeX document. Now, the second parameter, we can scale this image. Suppose we are having any figure which is of certain size. I will consider the size as 100%. Now, sometimes we want to expand that image beyond the 100%, or sometimes we need to compress the image to 50%, 40%, or some part or the fraction of that complete size. So how to do that? So let us, I will consider the same image. I will copy and paste this one. So I have considered the same. I will give the another name, label to this. So now here in this backslash include graphics commands, we have set the width and height for that image. Now, to insert the images in a proper scale, we have to give here the scale command. Scale. Now, how much percentage of the original graphics you have to include? So suppose I have to include only 50%. I have to compress my image to 50%. So I will give here the optional command in square brackets, scale equals to 0.5. If you have to scale to 60%, you have to give 0.6. If you have to scale 1.5 times, then you have to give here 1.5, and so on. So let us go and build this file, and let us wait for the output to produce. So definitely, whatever the original size of your graphics was there, your image will be compressed to 50%. Here in previous case, we have set the width and height. So accordingly, it has produced the output image. But sometimes we are having a very big file that we have to compress, or sometimes we are having a very small figure which we have to expand. So in that case, you have to use this scale command. So it is compiling, and it will quickly produce the output. See here. Now if you see here, the first figure is very small because we have set the width and height. Now this figure that is produced is 50% of its original size. 50% of its original size. So if you want to see the what is the original size, what I will do here, instead of this 1.5, I will keep as 1.0, and again go and compile this. So you will see what is the original size of your image. So again it is compiling. So you need to have a patience, because once it has created the output, it produces a wonderful output. The disadvantage in MS Word is once you insert the graphics, it is not numbered automatically, and once you insert the graphics and you insert some text around that graphics, your graphics get disturbed. But that is not the case in case of LaTeX. So for getting a beautiful document, you need to wait for some time. So if you see here, this is the first image that we have inserted, and this is our second image, which is in the original size, which is of the original size. So as this figure is very large, it is not fitting to our page. So that's why we need to compress this. So in such a cases, when your diagram, original diagram, is not fitting into the page, in that case you need to compress it to some percentage of its original images. So again I will go back and consider here the percentage 50%, that is the scale factor is 0.5. Now let us see how these figures can be rotated. Now to demonstrate how these figures can be rotated, again I will consider the new file, not new file, new figure here. I will consider the same figure and let us give here to rotate this figure. The command is, or the option or the parameter that you have to set is angle. So angle is equals to, now the user has to decide by how much angle your figure or your diagram is to be rotated. So suppose I have to rotate your figure by 45 degrees, so I will put the parameter as angle is equals to 45. So it will rotate your figure in anti-clockwise direction by 45 degrees. If you want to rotate your figure in clockwise direction by 45 degrees, then you have to give the sign minus 45. So I have set the angle by which I have to rotate my figure. So let us check the output. I will go again, click on build and view. It is compiling. So wait for some time as it will produce the output. So again you have to remember this, I have again rescaled as 0.5. So let us go back and check what will be the output for this third figure. This is figure number 1, this is figure number 2, and this is nothing but figure number 3. So you can even observe how these figures are numbered automatically. The process excited normally. So if you can see here, this is figure number 1, this is figure number 2 that we have rescaled to 50%, and this is the figure number 3 that we have rotated by 45 degrees. So if you can see here, the figure is rotated by 45 degrees and it has given the name automatically as figure 3. So in this way you can rotate your figures also. Now let us see if we are having the two figures which we need to place side by side. So I have one file, I will open it and I will show you how these figures is to be kept side by side. If you see here, these two figures are kept side by side. So in our document sometimes it is required to put the two figures side by side. So let us see how to put these two figures side by side. So for that, what I will do here, I will go back and now here you have to write down the commands. Now that is not possible by directly wizard. So I will have to type some commands here. So for that, what I will do here, I will begin figure. I have to type begin figure command. Now here inside this begin figure command, first I will use the command backslash entering. Why for backslash entering? It is to keep your files or the figures at the center. Then the next command is, we have to use now backslash subfloat. Backslash subfloat. Then in square bracket, you have to give the caption for that first figure. Caption for that first figure. Suppose I will give Raspberry Pi 1, suppose. Then inside this curly braces, we have to give the command backslash include graphics command. I will go and select here. So backslash include is having some optional parameters related to the size for that graphics. तो हियर आई विल सेट द विड्थ एंड हाइट. तो सपोज आई विल सेट विड्थ एज 3 सेंटीमीटर कॉमा हाइट एज 2 सेंटीमीटर एंड हियर यू हैव टू गिव द पाथ इमेज फाइल द पाथ फॉर योर इमेज. सो आई विल गो बैक एंड कॉपी दिस पाथ. सो यू कैन टेक सम अनादर पाथ. आई विल गो बैक एंड कॉपी दिस पाथ हियर एंड पेस्ट हियर. सो आई हैव क्रिएटेड द फर्स्ट फ्लोट. आई हैव क्रिएटेड द फर्स्ट फ्लोट. नाउ फॉर सेकेंड फ्लोट और द सेकेंड फिगर इफ यू कैन सी हियर वी हैव क्रिएटेड द फ्लोट फॉर दिस फिगर. नाउ वी हैव टू क्रिएट द फ्लोट फॉर दिस फिगर. वी हैव गिवन द नेम फॉर द फर्स्ट फिगर ऑल्सो. नाउ आई विल गो हियर. आई विल क्रिएट द अनादर सब फ्लोट. सब फ्लोट देन इन स्क्वेयर ब्रैकेट वी हैव टू गिव द कैप्शन फॉर दैट सेकेंड फिगर. सपोज आई विल गिव रास्पबेरी पाई 2 एंड देन इनसाइड दिस कर्ली ब्रेसेस वी हैव टू गिव द पाथ. सपोज आई एम यूजिंग अगेन द सेम backslash include कमांड include graphics कमांड. देन अगेन आई विल सेट द पैरामीटर्स एज विथ इज इक्वल्स टू 3 सेंटीमीटर एंड हाइट इज इक्वल्स टू 2 सेंटीमीटर. यू कैन सेट अकॉर्डिंग टू योर रिक्वायरमेंट एंड अगेन आई विल गो बैक एंड कॉपी द सेम फिगर. सपोज यू कैन इंसर्ट द डिफरेंट फिगर ऑल्सो बट टू सेव अवर टाइम आई एम टेकिंग द सेम फिगर. नाउ वी हैव क्रिएटेड द टू फ्लोट्स. दिस कर्ली ब्रेसेस यू नीड टू बी वेरी केयरफुल while opening and closing your curly braces. So we have opened it here and for this curly braces this is the end and for this curly braces this is the end. Now we have completed the two floats. You can have the third float also. Now we have given the name for this figure one as Raspberry Pi 1 and name to the second figure as Raspberry Pi 2. Now combinedly we have to give the name. Suppose we have this example like this. We have given the name to this figure, we have given the name to this figure, but we have not given this name to this figure. So what you have to do here, we have to go back here. Now here I have to give the caption for this figure. So I will write down backslash caption and inside this curly braces we have to give the caption. So here they are suppose models of Raspberry Pi, models of Raspberry Pi, and again you have to give the label. It is a good practice to always give the labels to your figures so that whenever you have to refer that figures it can be easily referred. So after some time we will see how to refer these figures. So here suppose I am giving the label as RASP. Suppose RASP. So it is complete. Now as we have to use the two figures side by side, we have used the two floats. One more command here you have to include, not command, here it is the package, and that package is backslash use package. Inside the curly braces we have to give SUBFIG subfig package. You have to include the subfig package to work this subfloat option. So we have completed writing the commands. So now go back and execute this source code and wait for the output PDF. So the compiling is going on. Hopefully we will not have any errors and our process will be excited normally. So if it has any errors, we have the chance how to rectify the errors, but more probably it will not give you the error because these commands are the simple commands. In most of the cases you will not require this subfloat option. So if you see here, it is process is excited normally. So we have not got, again I will go back and compile again. The process is going on. Is excited normally. Yes, here we are having. So the output obtained, if you see here, we have inserted the two figures which are side by side. Now these two figures are very close to each other and we have not inserted any spacing between these two. So what you have to do here, between these two subfloats, I will use the command backslash q quad. It will insert some space between these two figures. So I will go back and again compile this. So I have taken only the width and height as 3 cm and 2 cm. It has produced a very small images. So you can increase that width and height for the images so that you will get the bigger images. So again it is compiling and hopefully a space will be created in between these two figures. So let us check for this. See, so it has inserted some space between these two figures. So in this way you can insert the two figures side by side. So up till now what we have seen here, we have seen in the first figure how to insert a simple figure. Then in second option we have to see, or in this part of this document we have seen how to scale your images, how to compress or how to expand your images. Then inside this third figure or block, we have seen how to rotate your figure by some angle. And in this part, we have seen how to put your images side by side. Now, as we have inserted so many number of figures, we are having the 4 figures in our document. If you can see here. Now, sometimes in our document, such as thesis or book, we need to insert the list of figures. We have to print the list of all the figures that our document contains. So for that, what you have to do here, you have to write down the command. Wherever you want to insert that list of figures, you have to write down the command backslash list of figures. List of figures. If you can see here, automatically it's popped down. I will select this. So list of figures. So at the start of my document, I have inserted the list of figures. So I will go back, compile this, and let us check whether it is producing the list of figures or not. So that list of figures that will be produced will be along with the figure numbers, the name for that figure, and along with its page number, on which page number that figure is present. So this is the capability of LaTeX. So let us first observe what will be the output. So if you can see here, yes, you have to compile it twice. So again I will go back and compile it. For producing the correct list of tables or list of figures or list of abbreviations, all these, you need to compile or build your document at least twice. So if you can see here, it has produced the list of figures. So we are having the 4 figures, 1, 2, 3, 4, and along with the name for that figure and along with the page number. So if you can see here, figure number 1 and figure number 2, they are on page number 1. So it has displayed on page number 1. And if you can see here, figure number 3 and figure number 4, they are on page number 2. So here it is numbered as page number 2. So in this way it can produce the list of figures also. Now automatically it is titled as list of figures. We need not to type this list of figure text anywhere in our document. Now how to refer these figures inside the text? Now sometimes what we require in our document is, let us consider that as shown in figure. Now I have to, as shown in figure, suppose I will refer later on, as shown in figure, the Raspberry Pi has different models. Now let us consider at this point, as shown in figure, I have to insert this figure number. I have to insert this figure number 4. So what is the label for this figure number 4? That is RASP, RASP. So what I will write down here, I will type the command as shown in figure. I will write down the command backslash REF, and inside this curly braces, you have to give the label for that figure. So label for that figure 4 is RASP. So I will write down here RASP. So once I will type this command, automatically the output will have as shown in figure 4. So let us consider, I will go back and compile this and let us check for the output. Here this text will be printed somewhere in the document and it will refer your figure number 4. So whatever the label you will give here, that figure number will be inserted here. So let us go back and see. If you can see here, it has given the text here as shown in figure 4. This figure 4, number 4, we have not given here, just we have referred this figure by using this label. So here automatically it has produced the figure 4, because label of this figure we have given here in this command. So that's why this figure 4 is inserted here. So if you can put this command ref figure along with this label, it can be inserted anywhere. That figure will be referred anywhere in your document. So in this way, we can insert the various figures, diagrams or graphics in your LaTeX document. So already this video has taken much more time. We have gone very slowly so that you can understand in a better fashion, in an easier fashion. So friends, if you have understood the concept how to insert the graphics inside this LaTeX document, kindly like my videos, and if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe my channel. And if you like it much more, then you can even share my videos in your groups. So thank you very much.